Ahoy, mateys. Today we are going to the beach on the jungle map by using the Panther D exclusively. And it's a pretty rare sight for me to actually use this tank because I don't like it that much. Doesn't really fit my playstyle. It got a couple of weak spots. I mean, it got a couple of upsides too. But the weak spots are very annoying, at least for my kind of playstyle. While I do enjoy some sniping every now and then in my gameplay videos, this tank actually forces you into it. With the huge drawbacks of the very slow backpedal speed of only just 2 to 3 kilometers an hour on a flat surface, in combination with the slow turbo traverse speed, which makes it very hard to react to unexpected events, some enemies popping up from a direction you didn't expect them to. It kind of forces you to stay at long range, where we have more time to react, and where we can make use of the very good turret armor and the very well-designed gun mantlet, making use also of one of the best guns on this tier. Unfortunately, the map design on a lot of maps in this game makes it impossible to keep up playing like this, but at the start here with this game, we're actually able to stick to our role for quite a while. Despite his very unfavorable position, this KV-2 is able to give us a lot of trouble by deflecting some of my shots, and it takes a while for me until I get a good shot in. I guess he probably got damaged already by some of my allies, because with just 2 crew members we're getting the total knockout. And while the minimap shows that the enemy has a clear numerical superiority in our area, I'm not too concerned about it, because I'm in a very good position. And with my allies rushing forward like this, they are creating some kind of buffer. A buffer that I need to stick to my role, to medium to long range combat, kind of distracting the enemy from the front. Some of the enemies are actually very impatient, giving me some easy flanking shots, like this tiger right here. Now, with being hull down like this, I'm very confident in my ability to deflect any kind of incoming shot. And I could fight like this all day. The enemy has a very tough time closing in on our position. And what they actually would need to do is to rush up the kind of the little hill in the center of the map. You can't see it in the front right here in the picture, but I'm taking some glancing looks every now and then, because if someone pops up right there, that would be very dangerous for me. Now there's another easy flanking shot incoming right here. It's not a killing blow, and I need to wiggle with my turret a bit, because you can't be sure at this kind of distance what Sherman it actually is. I mean, in reality it just got a 75mm gun, but it could also have been one of the 76mm ones. And at this distance that we were fighting him right there, would have been dangerous for me to actually sit tight and do nothing. So I guess while it was unnecessary, safety comes first. Another thing worth mentioning is that the hill in the center of the map that I talked about a bit earlier is actually in firm control of our team. So I don't need to be afraid anymore of any kind of attacks coming from there. Now right here I'm having a bit of trouble fighting a couple of IS-1s. I don't know if it's luck or something on their side, but they are surprisingly resilient to my shots, deflecting and negating any kind of damage. Now with this situation in front of me, with all the ineffective shots on my part, I do get concerned, because I only got one ally left acting as some kind of shield for me. And this Tiger H1 right here that popped up onto my flank, so to speak, needs to recheck its Tiger Feeble, because he actually showed no kind of angling at all. Which is a very bad idea on this battle rating. The gun of the Panther D is actually superior to the 88mm, and well, it went through like butter, directly from the front, without any kind of angling. If you take a look at the minimap, you can see that there are a lot of allies incoming now, acting as reinforcements for our position. And the fighting here is dying down slowly. But while our team is getting the upper hand, which is of course a good thing, it gets a bit more difficult for me, because now I need to leave my very favorable hull down position that I had all the time, switching to some kind of offensive mode, And from my point of view, this Panther D is not very well suited for any kind of offensive action, and it will get a lot more dangerous now for us, being forced to move up and act aggressively. But all the complaints are of no use, since I need to keep in touch with the action, moving up with my team. And here we get another engagement going versus Jagdpanzer 38T. And as you can see, I aimed directly at the lower front plate, because even with the gun of the Panther, you might run into some trouble aiming at the upper front plate, because it has a very high degree of angling. Now from this point onwards, this game will get a lot more difficult for me, because I got two issues here, and the first thing is that I have actually trouble finding some enemies to engage, getting a good shot. And the other thing is a lot more positioning, because if I just keep on driving with my allies to the west, I will expose my flank eventually, like two vehicles like this Panzer IV. I'm actually watching here in the south. I mean, it's too far away for me to get a colored marker, but I'm taking a shot anyway. And I guess I got a disabling hit in. But there he goes again. Now my hesitant and indecisive style of gameplay will cost me a lot in a couple of moments, as you will see. I'm still trying to use this sandy hill as some kind of cover for my hull, but I'm exposing too much of my turret, giving this Sherman right here a way easier shot than I should have. And other than the Shermans we fought before, who only possessed 75mm guns, this one actually had a 76mm gun, the high velocity one, that is easily able to penetrate both my turret armor and the gun mantlet in most positions. And this T-34-85 gets a lucky shot in on my Capula. I mean, it was a lucky shot, because as you can see, in a couple of seconds this next shot is actually going to miss. So it's not that easy to hit me from this position. And while we are at it, I guess the Capula is the thing you need to watch out for most while going hull down with the Panther D. For one, it's very huge. And the second thing is that it got only 80mm of armor on the side. And this is way lower than, for example, the Capula armor of the Panzer III, which is rated at 100mm. And the only thing you need to can do about it, I guess, is wiggle the turret as best as you can. And so with this, we are concluding this game. I'm well aware that this is probably not my best Panther game overall, but it was still an okay game, I think. We got the Survivor Award going, we got the Heavy Metal Fury and the best score. And we were fighting at the beach, taking in some nice scenery on the way. But with that being said, I think it's time for me to sign off. And I hope to see you again on the next Warzone video of mine. Until then, and bye bye.